हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज मिनी सेठी। आई होप यू ऑल आर स्टेइंग हेल्दी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट शॉर्ट रन एंड लॉन्ग रन इक्विलिब्रियम एंड हाउ प्राइस एंड आउटपुट डिटरमिन अंडर मोनोपोली मार्केट। एज वी नो, मोनोपोली मार्केट इज अ सिचुएशन वेयर सिंगल सेलर सेलिंग हिज यूनिक प्रोडक्ट। मोनोपोली मार्केट इज अ सिचुएशन वेयर सिंगल सेलर सेलिंग हिज यूनिक प्रोडक्ट मीन्स हिज प्रोडक्ट डू नॉट हैव एनी क्लोज सब्स्टिट्यूशन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, Microsoft have a monopoly in personal computer, means their personal computers are very unique, they don't have any close substitution. Now we are going to talk about equilibrium under monopoly market. So what is equilibrium? Under equilibrium, we basically find a level of output where firm get maximum profit. Under equilibrium, we basically find a level of output where firm get maximum profit. At this point of output, firm feel balanced. Neither it want to increase output nor it want to reduce output. And in order to get equilibrium, two conditions must be satisfied. First condition is MR equal to MC. As we know, MR is marginal revenue, income that we receive from the sale of one additional unit. And MC is marginal cost that we incur on the production of one additional unit. First condition for equilibrium is MR equal to MC, and second condition is MC cut MR from below. We clearly understand these conditions with the help of this diagram. In this diagram, on x-axis we have output and y-axis we have cost, revenue and price. This blue one is AR, is average revenue curve of the firm. This black one, MR, is marginal revenue curve of the firm, and this red one is MC, is marginal cost curve of the firm. At this E point, you can see MR is equal to MC plus MC become equal to MR by cutting from below. You can see before E point, this red one is MC curve, this black one is MR curve. MC curve is below from MR curve. So at this point, at this E point, MC is equal to MR plus MC cut MR from below, means our both condition are satisfied at this E point. So E is our equilibrium point, and OQ is our equilibrium output, and OP is our equilibrium price. Now we are going to talk about short run equilibrium and price and output determined under monopoly market. At short time period, firm basically have three equilibrium: super normal profit, normal profit and loss. One by one we discuss about each. Firstly, we are going to talk about super normal profit. A firm gets super normal profit when AR is more than AC. A firm gets super normal profit when AR is more than AC. AR is average revenue per unit revenue. AC is average cost per unit cost. A firm gets super normal profit when per unit revenue is more than per unit cost. Now we will see super normal profit with the help of this diagram. In this diagram, on x-axis we have output and y-axis we have revenue, cost and price. This black one, MR, is marginal revenue curve. This blue one, AR, is average revenue curve. This red one, MC, is marginal cost curve. As we earlier discussed, in order to get equilibrium, two conditions must be satisfied: MR equal to MC and MC cut MR from below. And these two conditions will remain same in all equilibrium. You can see at this E point, MR is equal to MC plus MC cut MR from below. So E is our equilibrium point, and our equilibrium output is OQ and equilibrium price is OP. Now we are going to talk about where firm getting super normal profit. For knowing super normal profit, we need AR and AC, because a firm gets super normal profit when AR is more than AC. So here we have AR curve. We need to draw average cost curve. So this is our average cost curve, and we will draw average cost curve below from average revenue curve, because in case of super normal profit, AR is more than AC. You can see this blue one is our average revenue curve. This black one is our average cost curve. Average cost curve is below from average revenue curve. Now we join this point. So here RQ is our average revenue because this R point touch our revenue curve. And this TQ is our average cost because this T point touch our cost curve. In case of super normal profit, average revenue is more than average cost. You can see this RQ is more than TQ. And we can calculate profit when we minus average cost from average revenue. RQ is our average revenue, TQ is our average cost. RQ minus TQ is equal to RT. This RT is our profit. RT is equal to PF. This part SPRT is called our super normal profit. This is our super normal profit. Now we are going to talk about normal profit. A firm get normal profit when AR is equal to AC, or we can say that a firm get normal profit when per unit revenue is equal to per unit cost. In this diagram you can see on x axis we have output and y axis we have revenue, cost and price. This is MR curve of firm, this is AR curve, this is AC curve and this is MC curve. Is equilibrium point at this point MR is equal to MC and MC cut MR from below. As we earlier discussed, these two condition will remain same in all equilibrium, and OQ is our equilibrium output and OP is our equilibrium price. Now where is normal profit? A firm get normal profit where AR is equal to AC. So here RQ is our AR and RQ is our AC because this R point touch both average revenue curve as well as average cost curve. So at this R point average revenue is equal to average cost. So this point is called our normal profit point. Normal profit point. Now we are going to talk about loss. A firm get loss when AC is more than AR. AC is average cost per unit cost. AR is average revenue per unit revenue. A firm get loss when per unit cost is more than per unit revenue. In this diagram, you can see on x axis we have output and y axis we have cost, revenue and price. This black one is marginal revenue curve. This blue one is average revenue curve. This red one is marginal cost curve. E is equilibrium point. OQ is equilibrium output. OP is equilibrium price. Now where is loss? For knowing loss, we need average revenue and average cost, because in case of loss, average cost is more than average revenue. So this is our average revenue curve. We need to draw our average cost curve. And this is our average cost curve. And we will draw average cost curve above from average revenue curve, because in case of loss, average cost is more than average revenue. So this black one is average cost curve. This blue one is average revenue curve. You can see average cost curve is above from average revenue. We will join this line. So here SQ is our average cost, RQ is our average revenue. In case of loss, average cost is more than average revenue. You can see SQ is more than from RQ. We can calculate loss when we minus average revenue from average cost. SQ is our average cost, RQ is our average revenue. SQ minus RQ is equal to SR. This SR, this part is our loss. SR is equal to KP. So this PKSR, this part is called our loss. Now we are going to talk about long run equilibrium and price and output determined under monopoly market. At short time period, it can be possible firm get super normal profit or loss. But at long time period, firm can control its output and cost because all factors are variable. Second thing, in case of monopoly, only single seller selling his unique product, means no other firm can enter in the market. That's why at long time period, most probability firm will get super normal profit. In very few cases, it can be possible firm get normal profit. At long time period, monopoly mostly gets super normal profit. Now we will see super normal profit with the help of this diagram. Diagram of super normal profit, same as we discussed in short time period. Only difference is that here we take long run average cost and long run marginal cost, because we are talking about long time period. Same on x axis we have output and y axis we have cost, revenue and price. This MR is marginal revenue curve. AR is average revenue curve. LAC is long run average cost. LMC is long run marginal cost. E is equilibrium point. At this point, MR is equal to MC plus MC cut MR from below. OQ is equilibrium output and OP is equilibrium price. Now, where is super normal profit? A firm can get super normal profit when AR is more than AC. So, here our AR is RQ.
skew because this R point touch our average revenue curve and our average cost is TQ. This T point touch our average cost curve. In case of super normal profit, average revenue is more than average cost. You can see this RQ is more than TQ, and we can calculate profit when we minus average cost from average revenue. Our average revenue is RQ and our average cost is TQ. RQ minus TQ is equal to RT. This RT is our profit. RT is equal to SP. So this part PSRT is our super normal profit. Super normal profit. And in case of monopoly, firm mostly gets super normal profit at long time period. This is all about short run and long run equilibrium and how price and output determine at a monopoly market. I think you got it, and thank you so much for watching this video. Bye, take care.